go to Stephen, who's a Leeds fan. A bad night for Stephen. Steve, good evening.
Hi, Steve.
Good evening, Jeremy. Good evening, Dean.
Were you at the game? Or did you watch?
I was in the city end, and it should be called the empty end. It's an absolute disgrace. There were more Leeds fans in their end than their own fans. Now, them first two people that phoned up was not Leeds fans. How they can mention Steve Bruce and Kevin Blackwell in the same sentence as Bielsa is an absolute, it's criminal. I mean, Steve Bruce had a worse record at Newcastle than Jamie did at Villarrica. That's how bad it was.
Yeah, but listen, Stephen, regardless of whether it's the empty ad or whatever, you can ban them. They're sensational, Man City, but it's not,
Jamie,
good. It's not good enough. 7-0.
Probably the best team in the world behind Liverpool. They were outstanding tonight. But them first two people, I mean, people saying sack Bielsa tonight. Are they mental? Is God? Is the greatest manager we've probably ever had behind Don Revy?
Well,
16 years back in the Premier League. It's unreal. How can you say sack him?
You think back the years, you're thinking Leeds need to be in the Premier League. It's a massive club. And he like drifted. He come in and he's took the club into the Premier League playing all action football with young players running their guts out for the club. The fans love it. He's got a way of playing that nobody could cope with in the Championship. He's come up into the Premier League. They've done it again. And they're going to have a little bit of a blip. I don't think it's time to panic. They're a really good team. You've just had some injuries to your key players.
Yeah.
Liverpool lost Van Dijk last year. And look what happened to the rest of them. Well, the effect.
Sorry to interrupt you, mate. But if Calvin Phillips was in midfield with Adam Forshaw's not great. But with Phillips next to him, it's outstanding. And if Phillips is not injured tonight, we don't concede 7. We probably concede 6.
He hasn't even been playing him in midfield, Stephen. He's been playing him centre-half in the back three.
He was. No, not recent games. The last two games, mate, has been pushed back up to midfield. But Phillips is out, Bamford's out, Cox out. You know, brilliant players.
What do you think's wrong then?
Well, nothing. Just recently, I mean, I know we're near the bottom of the league, but recently we've played the best teams. We're playing Liverpool Boxing Day, we've played City, we've played Chelsea. Champions of Europe, Champions of the Premier League. We're not, you know, we're...
Right, you've played 17 games though, Stephen. You ain't played 4.
Pardon?
You've played 17 games now, not 4, you know?
I know, but obviously the squad's been depleted most of the season, but, you know, we've got some big players coming back. I think we'll definitely be all right. Listen, Burnley are worse than us, Norwich are worse than us, Southampton are worse than us, Watford are worse than us. There's loads of teams worse than Leeds. Loads.
Is that what you want, though? Are you happy with that? You're thinking about the teams that are worse than you? Leeds last season were exciting to watch. This season, it's not so much.
Yeah, good point, Jeremy.
No, but yeah, I mean, to get to the next step, you've got to put your hand in your pocket again.
I know, but listen, we're not a billionaire club.
No.
Our owners worth 300 million, you know. We're not a billionaire club. We can't afford these £100 million players. Mm. We've got a championship squad, which are playing Premier League football, and we're doing good. We're doing well. We stayed up last season, and we'll be fine this season.
Spot on. Listen to Jamie.
Stephen. No, listen, I think Leeds will be okay. I watched them against Stamford Bridge and I thought they was excellent. They really were. They was unlucky not to get something from the game. But come on, when you're turning up and getting beat 7-0.
Yeah, but it can happen. But where do you think they should finish then, Leeds? Where do you think Leeds United, as a football club, look at the players they've signed and how much money they're spending. Where do you think a fair place for them to finish?
You'd say mid-table, but because you've got a progress.
I think they will finish there. Mid-table.
I disagree. I don't think they will. Let's go to John, who's a Man City fan. John, good evening.
Hi, yeah, John. Sorry about that, lads. I was at the empty hat again, again. I was part of the 27,000 that used to turn up at Main Road in the third division, you know, support since 2008, whatever. So, Leeds fans in our end, don't think so. Flattered today. That could have been double figures. That could and should have been double figures. And that was all done without a number 9 on the park. Mm. It was just playing with them. So Rodrigo was magnificent in the middle of the park. Did Bielsa not see that we had 10 yards of space that Kevin De Bruyne and Rodrigo were alternating in?
I know.
It was just picking off passes. If that's a manager of the highest quality who everyone doffs the cap to, schoolboy had a... He should have put man markers in there. And nullified Rodrigo and Kevin De Bruyne, who just pulled them apart. It was easy. That was the easiest game I've watched for a
while. Were
they
one of the worst teams you've seen at the Etihad?
No, they played good football. But when your game plan is for Meslier to bowl it out to Luke Ayling, who then fires it over to the halfway line, to Rafinha, we're intercepting that. What have you got? You've got nothing else. You could have had Calvin Phillips on there. You could have had whoever else on there. Wouldn't have made one jot of difference tonight. City were just at the straps, at the races, and at them all game long. I mean, it should have been Bernardo should have scored in the first minute, I think it was. And that was, for the season he's having, that was
a moment.
Yeah. Do you know what I said to Jamie before the game? I said, before the kickoff, I said, they've lost Aguero, right? It's a lot of goals to lose. How are they going to get around losing Aguero? Obviously they are by the football they're playing, but will it cost you? Because you've sat there and watched Aguero win a game when it's 0-0 or it's 1-1 and Aguero gets on the end of something that no other player in the world would get on the end of and wins you a game like that.
Dean, let me jump on that one. Right?
Go on then.
So last year, Aguero scored how many goals for us? 4. We won the title, 4 goals. So I came on to start the season and I said, not bothered about a number 9 because goals team was going, you lost out on Messi, you lost out on Ronaldo, you lost out on... I said, mate, I'm just going to name you 9 players that will get you 10 plus goals. Foden, Mahrez, De Bruyne, Bernardo. Do you want me to carry on?
Yeah.
It just goes on. So City play a rotating front 6. You'll see John Stone flying up the right wing today.
I know, he looked like Cafu.
Yeah, so
he's flying.
You'll see Phil Foden dropping into the centre midfield. You'll see him on the right flank, the left flank, centre forward position. De Bruyne the same, Mahrez the same, Rodrigo the same. Well, not Rodrigo so much, but he'll hold the park, the centre of the park, and it's just dictating rhythm and tempo. And then when Gundogan comes on, what a wonderful footballer. And the way to beat Manchester City, break the rhythm, break the tempo, take an eternity with dead balls, roll round as though you're half dead, break the rhythm.
Nice to watch, though, at the minute. Yeah. Nice to watch.
Yeah,